Hi students, so this video is introducing your core vocabulary for this lesson. I think you'll really like it because most of the words, if not all of them, are relating to astronauts and outer space and things like that. And I know that that's very interesting to you guys. So the first vocabulary word is the right stuff. It's a noun. It's a 1983 movie about the first seven American astronauts ever. So 1983 is a pretty long time compared to when you guys were born. So you might not be aware of that movie. The second vocabulary word is John Glenn, which is one of the first seven American astronauts. So he was one of the first men to ever go into outer space. That's really awesome. Rekindle, your third vocabulary word, excuse me, boys and girls, is rekindle, which means to reawaken or brought back to life. So, you know, coming back to school and after the summer, it can rekindle your love for learning and things like that after a long, relaxing summer break. Graduate school. Your fourth vocabulary word is graduate school, a school for post-college study. So graduate school, it would be, so first you go to elementary school, then it's middle school, high school, and then you go to college. And after you graduate college, you can go back to college. School never stops sometimes. And that would be graduate school. So it's after you go to college your first time, and then you would go back and you can go to graduate school. The fifth vocabulary word is MIT, which is a university in Massachusetts famous for teaching science and engineering. So maybe one day if you're thinking about going to college, that might be a college you're interested in if you're into teaching science and engineering. Your fifth vocabulary or your sixth vocabulary word is NASA, which is a noun. It's the United States agency that oversees the space program. So I know maybe some of you guys are familiar with NASA. I believe they have a NASA place here in Houston. So that's the agency that's over all of the rockets and everything and the astronauts that go into outer space, which is really awesome. The next vocabulary word is space shuttle. It's a type of spacecraft used by NASA from 1981 to 2011. So they no longer use this type of spaceship, a spacecraft, but it was once very used and popular for NASA. The next vocabulary word is Hubble Space Telescope, a space telescope that orbits the Earth. So this is really awesome. It's not even a telescope that we look out of. It's above and it's floating outer space over our Earth. Isn't that amazing, boys and girls? Your next one, a vocabulary word, is a spectrograph. It is a type of camera attached to the Hubble Space Telescope. So it's a Hubble Space Telescope and a spectrograph that's on top of it, rotating and around the Earth. That's so crazy and amazing. The next vocabulary word is capability or power, ability. So that means, it's, for example, you all have the capability to be amazing scholars and amazing fifth graders, which you are. So it just means the power and the ability to. The next vocabulary word is expense, which means cost. So for example, I know you've heard of expensive, but it's anything dealing with the cost of something. The next vocabulary word is airlock, a chamber astronauts may pass through when entering or exiting a spacecraft. So it's a part of a spacecraft, or kind of like a door that they have to go in and out of, astronauts. Oops. Oh, sorry, boys and girls. The next word is momentum. It's the force or movement. So just like when you're walking or when you were to push a swing or something like that, that the force that's keeping it moving back and forth if you have a swing. So the momentum. And lastly, your vocabulary word is tether. It is a cord fastening something or someone to a base. So a tether could be like a seatbelt or something that has you connected or attached to fastened to a base. So boys and girls, That's your core vocabulary for this lesson. I hope you find it really interesting. Now that I'm done reviewing it, I want you to take the time to go over, you read it for yourself. Look up, if you want to, look up some of these things like the right stuff and different things that you might not be aware of because they might be, before you were born or you just want to see what they're really about. Also, in your writing and reading journal, make sure that you write, practice some using some of these vocab, most all of them, not some. All of your vocabulary words, and just so you become and you enter and put these implement these in your vocabulary, and that you understand them more. So I hope that you enjoyed it, and that this is your core vocabulary for this lesson. Bye bye.